Hey guys, welcome back. As you can see, today's video is landscape painting. I will show you in this part here, in the first part, how I painted the cloud part here. And in the second part, I'm gonna show you how I painted the woods and the lake part here, the water reflection. That's the palette that we're gonna use for this painting here. 7 colors. And I premixed them. For the underpainting, as you can see. I did this just to cover the white of the canvas. We have some very dark parts here, and I think it's always easier to get this thing covered before we start with a final layer of color. This next mixing process, as you can see. For the final layer, these are the brushes that we're gonna use. Rounds, flats, very soft ones, smaller ones, bigger ones. Yeah, here we start to build up this whole thing. After the underpainting is dry, starting with the brightest part here. Putting in the clouds. The lower end, as you can see. And I used colors here basically without any medium at all. I did this because I wanted to have good coverage, and this is achieved best when you use the color straight out of the tube, what I did here. I'm building up the first cloud that we have here, as you can see, the white from the whitish yellowish from the sun. Reflecting from the cloud, first layer of clouds here. Letting them melt into the background, as you can see. The difficult part here is to match the colors from the very bright, nearly yellowish white color here that we have on the foreground left side. To the more bluish color that we have, that we plan to put on the upper right side. And you see on the palette, I have premixed set of colors. And that will help me to make it possible, this whole blending process. So that we have a really nice transition from the lighter color to the more bluish, cooler color. As you can see here. So we basically then start to build up the clouds as they appear, and they tend to get darker the further away we get from the sun. That's something that you have to put in to make it look realistic. Still a warm color here. It's a brownish one. And now we start to apply the... it becomes more coal. There's more blue to it. More purple. And so we basically build up this thing here. Getting darker and colder. More purplish, more bluish. The more we come away from the sun. And here now I start to add already the first layer of details. And it's basically a pretty easy process. You grab some lighter color. I mean, not a completely white color, but a lighter color here. And put it on where I think it belongs. And then you grab, in this case here, a fan brush, very soft one, and start to blend. Yeah, this you build up a very quick and very efficient way of new layers to this clouds here. And I will repeat this process, basically the whole process here, while painting these clouds here. Adjusting them, making them brighter and darker. And I basically brush them on to the still wet color that we have put in on this sitting here. See again here, for a little bit brighter color. Trying to establish more layers to this cloud. And this is the good thing when you work with those oils that I have, those modern mixable oils, that you basically can achieve a very nice soft transition with this layering here. Because the color that we have as a first layer here is still wet, so it makes this blending far more easy than when you would try to do it with acrylics. Next layer of clouds. I mean, see, it looks pretty rough, pretty not so nice. A little bit blending with the fan brush, and then it really becomes 3D looking. Here we are now already putting on the even darker tones. These are not yet the darkest tones that we have to apply. But you see that I basically put in some holes here, some windows to the cloud. This bluish color from the background, from the sky that we have. And adjusting the colors, trying to build up more 3D looking parts of the cloud. New layers again on this even darker surface here. And I again and again go back and start to add new layers, new details, new parts where the sun hits clouds. And you have to be careful, you will not to overdo this by using a too bright color. So rule of thumb, the color is brighter the more you step to the sun. And gets darker. Also the highlights, the more you go to the back of this cloud here. And now we have the second darkest color that I apply now. Using a very soft blender brush to connect those two colors. Toying around with the windows and adding darker colors here, even more darker colors. And this here is now the darkest color. And with this simple way of blending on the painting surface, you achieve very quick, a very nice transition between those colors. And again, this might be boring to watch it for the fifth time here, but I think this is one of the key parts when it comes to doing such a big cloud, that you put in a lot of details and a lot of different layers on this cloud. This is achieved by just adding some highlights. Even here in the darker part. Rubbing the color into the still dry, it's still wet darker color here. adjusting the whole thing. Ah, and that's how the cloud looks like after this whole mixing, blending, adjusting. So that's it for today's lesson here, cloud painting part, and I got a ton of other cloud painting videos here.